Oh!
You see?
Already got her rolling. Hi camera. It's midnight. This is how it all begins. At a podunk Valero about 20 miles south of San Antonio.
And so the journey begins.
Turn your music up.
Life's like a road that you travel on. There's one day here and the next day gone. Sometimes you bend.
Sometimes you win, sometimes you lose.
No, it's not. It's like sometimes you bend, sometimes you stand, sometimes you turn your back to the wind. There's a world outside every dungeon door. The blues won't haunt you anymore. Yeah, but you can't even put that in here because you got copyright issues.
We'll say we do not own the rights to this song.
We do not own the rights. My road tripping song.
Travel on, there's one day here and the next day gone. Sometimes you bend, sometimes you stand, sometimes you turn your back to the wind. There's a world outside every darkened door, where blues won't haunt you anymore. Where the brave are free and lovers soar, come ride with me to the distant shore. We won't hesitate to break down the garden gate. There's not much time left today, yeah.
This is so much nicer than what we've been doing.
Oh, yeah. And it's like, not a single ladybug inside of this dang trailer.
It looks like there's no moss on it, or like, that's it. Ooh.
Tile floors.
Ooh. Ooh, you got a select.
It even smells good.
Oh.
Does it smell like ladybug? Oh.
Is this the Taj Mahal?
First morning. Home sweet home for the weekend. Ooh-wee.
You want to just
You want to go around the backside?
No. This is the backside. Trying to. Yeah, it's just a nice doe. There's two of them there. It's a doe and a little fawn. She's watching us though. Dude, they just don't care, man.
We're. Out here in La Salle, finally got here. Drove about 8 hours from North Texas. Got out down here about around 1 o'clock in the morning. And first day out here hunting this big open field of mesquite trees with a water trough and a really nice feeder. came just rolling up to the blind. We saw three does, one big doe, two fawns, and just excited to see what we see today. Well, we got the story of another guy that lives out here that a big 8-point buck was being dragged off the road by a bobcat. And it's like 17 3/4, 18-inch spread, real nice 8-point. So hopefully we see a live one over here today, and we'll either let it live today and take it another day, or we'll take it tonight and stick it in the freezer. So, wish us luck.
Morning number one, right at 6 o'clock right now, about 45 minutes till light. We'll see what the day holds, but I'm thinking we're gonna see something nice, but we'll see. I feel good about today. A little bit chilly, had the rain last night, get all the scent out of the air, be a good day. First morning really out here. It's about 15-20 minutes before shooting light. We got in and threw some corn out with using the gator on this big open field. Got probably the feeder going off in about 10 minutes. Still too dark to see anything, but maybe hoping that big old 9-point comes back out. Let us think about shooting him some more.
It's gonna be a tempting deer.
It is. I don't know if I'll be able to pass on him a second time like that, but we'll see. Maybe some javelinas will come out this morning, but this feeder, we accidentally didn't set the throw time in the evening, only in the morning. So everything that's probably as far as tracks and everything that are there are probably from the morning tracks for the most part. So I think it's gonna be a pretty good morning. It rained a little bit last night, so it's kind of like a very calm morning, about a little under 50 degrees. We'll see what happens.
Moving back towards the feeder. I'm 90% sure that's the
as soon as he turns, I'm blasting him. Dropped him.
Yep, you got him. He's dead. Good shot, dude. That's a far shot.
Got him. He's dead as dead.
Oh, yeah.
Dude, that's a far shot.
I've been after a coyote since I was like 12 years old. It's only my second coyote ever.
Nice.
That's a beautiful coyote.
That is, man.
You see what I had
nice
to,
full fur.
You see what I had to do right here on my butt? I'm literally sitting on my camera bag just so I can see how this damn boy.
You should get taller.
Yeah, that ain't gonna happen.
All right, Austin just shot a coyote.
And I'm taller than John now.
Barely. Real nice looking coyote too.
Yep.
But let's go check it out.
It's a pretty dog. Song dog, baby. He pooped himself. He done pooped himself. Actually, let's see if it's a he or a she. It's a he. Dang, dude. Look at that shot.
That's a great shot.
Oh, he stinks. What a beautiful dog, man. Look at that. Dude, look at those teeth.
Those are white. Wow.
Dude. Oh my gosh, dude. This is the most beautiful coyote I think I've ever seen. Oh my gosh, dude. Right there. So I got him a little bit quartering away. Or she's been like, yeah, quartering away. That's actually not too bad of an exit hole for a 308.
Mm-hmm.
I'm doing something with this coyote, man. Big.
Wow.
Big, dude. That's as big as my hand.
You got small hands.
Thanks. Still got hands. It's as big as my hand.
Fair.
I can't
like
tell.
A kid size 3.
That's a big, big, big.
And these are 11 and a halves.
I think it's the biggest hoof print I've ever seen. I can't tell if it's a pig or a deer. Oh, it's a deer. Because there's this other one right there. Dude, if he's putting his... If he's getting these bad boys in the ground... That means he's big. He's heavy. And I don't think it's the same deer that we saw
this morning. That was this morning, too.
Maybe. It depends. Where's his other track at?
Because it's wet. See? Right here. He's sinking down in that ground.
Yeah. He came out, looks like. Where'd he come from? I can't tell. I can't tell if he came from right here or if he came down the trail. Came down the trail?
Yeah.
There. Yeah, that's him.
Yep. Right here?
Yep. Oh. I think this is the afternoon spot for sure. Maybe the morning. Yeah, so I say morning too. Because then we can always do a like last ditch Monday morning back at the field, and we'll for sure get something.
Yeah.
At that point though, we'll just have to do a oh right under the blind.
Oh my lord, dude.
Big huge buck, dude.
Maybe that's the one that we're seeing. Holy crap.
I couldn't. That was a huge deer.
Let's see how close I can get to him.
Do you want to go back and grab the 308 and try to sneak up on him? Yeah, no, he's got to be close by, though. Javelinas down, and the deer, I dropped him, but then he got back up and he took off running and I couldn't get another shot off at him. So I don't know if y'all want to come here and help me look.
Has its grown yet?
Okay.
So I was gonna wait for it to throw and wait like 10 minutes to come over there.
If you guys hurry right now, I don't know if Jolie wants to shoot. There's like 10 javelinas sitting in the road on the way in here, and they've been eating, and there's 2 dead ones literally that I've shot, and there's like 10 dead ones. So if she wants to shoot some javelinas, they're just chilling there.
Okay, sounds good. I'll text you.
Okay, cool. I'm gonna go ahead and get down, I guess, and I'm gonna try to look for this deer. But dude, he got up and he dropped. He spun in a circle on the ground. He got up and he ran off. So I don't know where he, like, I'm kind of.
It looks like
the way he was running, dude, looks like a hit him in the shoulder, but he dropped, man. That was like, oh yeah, I got him. And then he got up and he ran. I don't know, man. I'm gonna go start looking. Whenever, just call me whenever you're on your way. All right,
will do.
All right, cool. Yeah. Oh, and yeah, if you think you're like easier, it's gonna be if. Never mind. I'm gonna look. I'm just all flustered, man.
Okay.
All right. Cool.
You're good.
All right. Bye.
We'll be there in a minute.
All right. Cool. Bye. These javelinas are still there. Okay, I gotta go look for the deer. Go on. Get. Go on. Go on. Go on. On those javelinas. I don't really feel like getting attacked by javelinas tonight. I don't know if I got it on camera or not, but there was one that was squealing at me right there in the bushes. I said, all right, I'm gonna turn around. And then, oh goodness. Yeah. So after I had that one started squealing at me, and the other ones came out of the bush. Just then, it started coming at me. Those things are only like 40 pounds, but I think it would mess my day up. So I think I'm better off just waiting for backup on that one. But yeah.
All right, ladies and gentlemen. Austin shot his deer, and now we can't find it. It's pitch black out here, so wish us some luck.
I have no idea where he's going.
That's probably him. Knocked that off right there. After I shot that,
dumb rabbit, right?
After I... I'll one up you. So after, here it is. Here's his tracks, dude.
Yeah.
I think those are these ones.
Which
side was he facing?
But anyways, after I shot that at that bobcat, I had the shell casing, I had a rabbit behind me, and I threw the casing at the case at the rabbit, and I hit the rabbit, and he just like looked at the shell. He didn't even move. He just looked at the shell casing, sniffed it, and like went back to eating. I was like, I can't believe I didn't get that on video.
Well, it is the next morning. We never found the deer last night. Couldn't blow up the footage, so I was watching the shot over and over and over on my little 2-inch by 3-inch screen. I don't know. We found blood. We found where he went. We just couldn't find him. And he went over a couple hundred yards just from where the last sign of him was. So I think that there's a chance I could have gut shot him. I don't know how, but I think that's what it is. I found one speck of just brown liquid that kind of looked like gut matter, stomach matter. So he might, he's dead somewhere. It's just a matter of if we can find him this morning or not. And, we looked and looked and looked. So, we'll see if we can find him this morning. That stuff is just so thick that, I don't know if it's going to happen or not. But I'm trying to keep my hopes up in the chance that we somehow find him. But that's about what it is. So, we'll see. You know, this happens with hunting sometimes. And when it does, you have to deal with it. But it's never your intention to do it. You never mean to do it. I surely didn't mean to do it. I would rather drug him right out of the field there. So when he got up last night and took off running, I was blown away that he actually got up and ran away. So maybe we'll find him this morning. Keep my hopes up. So we'll see.
Dude, they smell so bad. I almost just threw up. I'm laughing, but I'm not joking. Ugh. I almost just threw up. We found the deer!
We finally found the deer. Shot it at about, 5:30 last night?
Yeah.
Just, it was getting dark. We ran off. It ran off. We started looking for it for till about 10 p.m. last night. Finally called it quits because it was getting cold and dark. Knew we weren't going to be able to find it. Got up around 7:30 this morning, started looking again, and now it is
like
10:30. So we cut a path through the brush. We're about to show y'all how far back it went.
So far.
Finally got it. I have no sense of distance at this point.
Yeah, me neither, man. It's like some music, some bags.
Be the worst ones around.
For real. We promise to find your deer within about a week. And there she lies.
And there she lies. Well, he.
Would spin around, him around, but
He's a little rigid.
A little bit.
All right.
He's pretty heavy. Well, it's been about a day since we've been back. Kind of there towards the tail end of the hunt. I know we don't have a lot of good footage of the deer or anything like that. We were just at that point, you know, me and John both had work on I guess Tuesday morning, since that was a Monday. So we kind of had to hightail it out of there. So it wasn't really our top priority at that point to get real good footage. It was more of our top priority to just hurry up and get out of there. It was a huge, huge success just finding that deer in general. We literally had, that was probably, as far as hunting goes, that was the most ups and downs that I've ever had just in any hunting situation. Just the amount of highs and lows that entire experience brought upon us. You know, it took us probably about, it probably took us an hour or so to get that deer out of where it was. When we found it, we didn't have the camera on us or anything like that. I'm sure it's going to be very apparent. You'll be able to see that, you know, we found it, we got there, and we got it out of there, and we were pretty much on a hurry, because at that point it had been sitting there for about 15 hours. So my biggest concern, that deer was kind of a little bit bloated at that point. It was kind of getting warm. My biggest concern was just getting it cleaned and getting it out of there and getting it home. So that's really kind of what it came down to. But we have some really good pictures of it, really good still shots that really does truly show off how nice of a deer it is. But the overall experience was just absolutely awesome. You know, I got to go down to South Texas and finally got to hunt South Texas, which has been a dream of mine to do for a long, long time. And we ended up getting very successful. Me and John both were very successful, and I was able to harvest an extremely nice, I guess we'll measure it once I get it back, but it's gonna be going to the taxidermist. Just my rough guesstimate, that deer's probably gonna score somewhere between 130 and 140, maybe not quite 140, probably, I'm thinking like 130, like low 130s is probably what he's gonna score, which, you know, isn't a huge, huge, huge deer, but for me, it's probably gonna be my personal best deer. So I'm extremely happy with that, and you know, it was an absolute great time. Huge deer, you know, as the video will show, it's gonna have the absolute highs and highs and the absolute lows of lows. Which, I mean, you couldn't script it any better than that. We literally, I was pretty much given up. I'd given up on finding the deer at that point, actually. And Jolie came and she said, you know, let's go check the creek or whatever. And there was a dried up creek bed there, kind of where we originally found signs of him. She said, let's just check it one more time. And you know, I said, all right, I'm gonna go try this one more time, get back to my basics, you know, just go from spot to spot. You can't just, you know, they don't just stop bleeding. I mean, they sometimes do, but that's very, very rare. So we went back to where our last sign of him was, and you know, we literally stood there and found another sign. It wasn't even blood. It was a broken piece of cactus is what actually did it. And John found a broken piece of cactus, and I'm not sure if we got that on video or not, but you know, that started the crumb trail up again, and we followed it and followed it and followed it, and we found him. And I cannot be more grateful for finding that deer and everything that went into it. But yeah, we did lose a little bit of footage there at the end just from being in such a hurry to get out of there. Literally found that deer on our last-ditch efforts. We got home way later than we wanted to because of how long that took and everything. But in the end, it was totally worth it. And I'm sure, as all the footage is going to show, it was one heck of a weekend. So, with that being said, I think I'm signing off, and thus ending the LaSalle hunting journey for this year, or at least for me, for this year at least. So, till we hit back to out there near the home turf, my little 14 acres, and we'll go see if we can get it done there this year. But you know, if nothing else happened the rest of the year, I think this has been a great year. So, till probably till next weekend. Signing off.